So today we are going to discuss about what is SAP HANA. So what is SAP? Already we discussed. So SAP stands for Systems, Applications and Products for Data Processing. Okay, already we discussed this one. SAP stands for Systems, Applications and Products. Okay, so already we discussed at the time of SAP demonstration. SAP stands for Systems, Applications and Products. So systems means operating systems. Like SAP, already we discussed, SAP is voice independent. So we can able to install SAP on Windows, Linux, AX, Mac OS, Solaris. Okay, so systems. So what we are using the systems means the OS for SAP installation. So systems means operating systems. And applications means here. Systems means operating systems. Application means SAP applications. Each like ERP, CRM, SRM, SCM, four applications are there. So those are applications. So these are applications. And what about the products? SAP products like EHP 5, EHP 6, EHP 7. So those are the products. So by using systems, operating systems, by using the applications, SAP developed applications, by using the products, SAP products, we process the data. That is nothing but SAP. Already we discussed at the time of SAP basis demonstration. So next we'll discuss about HANA, SAP HANA. High performance analytical and appliance see here. HANA stands for High Performance Analytical Appliance. Okay, so for example, if you take the functional modules, already we discussed this one also, like SD, FICO, and HR, and MM, PM. So if you want to learn these function modules, compulsory we need domain knowledge. So compulsory we need domain knowledge. For example, if you take SAP SD, MBA marketing people are eligible, means MBA marketing background is mandatory for learning SAP SD. Okay, so in the same way, FICO, MBA finance people are eligible. Otherwise, BCom, like MCom people are also eligible. That's a finance background. Okay, so if you take SAP HR, so minimum one year knowledge on SAP HR activities. Okay, like MBA HR people are eligible for this module. And if you take a SAP MM material management, so BTech civil people are eligible for this course. BTech civil people are eligible for this. So if you take any module, any functional module, compulsory need domain knowledge. This is, so this is a module, this is a domain knowledge. For example, if you take Java, C, C++ are the domain knowledge for learning Java. The same way, if you want to learn SD, FICO, HR, MM, they need some domain knowledge. Okay. In the same way, if you want to learn SAP HANA, if you want to learn SAP, I'm talking about HANA administration. So HANA two types, administration, development, we'll discuss later. So if you want an SAP HANA admin, so compulsory or background should be SAP basis. So this is like SAP HANA is like SAP basis. So what are the concepts in SAP basis, like installation and user administration, role administration, and like backups, recoveries, okay, in license installation, monitoring activities, everything is same like SAP basis. So if you want to learn SAP HANA admin, compulsory our background should be as a basis consultant. Okay, so understood this point. So next to, if you take SAP HANA two types, administration and development. Okay, so just now we'll discuss now. So if you want to learn SAP HANA administration, our background should be SAP basis. And if you want to learn SAP HANA development, SAP BW. SAP BO. BW or BA, both are same. So if you want to learn SAP development, HANA development, so these modules people are eligible. If you want to learn SAP HANA administration, the basis consultants are eligible. Got it? So this is. So next thing is, so just now we discussed high performance analytical appliance, HANA stands for. Okay, what is high performance? So for example, if you take traditional database, so if you take traditional databases are like Oracle database and Max DB, DB to DBA, MySQL and Sybase. But high performance is till now we have only one database, that is HANA. Traditional databases. So why these are called as traditional database means relational databases. So compulsory we need hard disk. So whenever we are using these type of databases, for example, if you take SAP basis, SAP ECC installation, so we have three layers: presentation layer, application layer, and database layer. It means so SAP having no space. SAP having no space. Each and everything should be stored in database, no? So that's why we need a database layer. Okay. So what we perform in SAP logon, those are stored in the database only. Database means the drive, like a D drive or E drive, what we assigned at the time of installation, SAP installation. Okay. So if you take Oracle. Whenever we are using Oracle as a database, so everything is stored in database only. So like MaxDB, DB2DB, MySQL, Sybase. It means so separate layer. SAP having no space, each and everything should be stored in database only. But this is HANA, high performance. It means so in-memory database, in-memory. Okay, so data is not stored in SAP, not in hard disk. The transaction data is not stored in SAP. Why? Because SAP have no space. Already we discussed this point. And not stored in database. This is not like a traditional database. So in middle of SAP and the hard disk, we have RAM. So in middle of the hardware and the software, this is software, this is hardware, we have RAM, random access memory. The data is stored RAM only. Instead of hard disk, the data is stored in RAM only. Okay. So why? Because SAP having no space, already we discussed that one. Okay. So the next option is hard disk. So until so present, like if you take ECC installation, compulsory we need to assign D drive for SAP installation, means that's a data storing purpose. But here, so no need any hard disk, everything is stored in RAM only. So transaction data is stored in RAM only. Okay. So high performance, what is the meaning of high performance? So see here. This is application layer. This is presentation layer. Like user interface, presentation layer, nothing but user interface. Okay. So if you take traditional, this is a traditional database. Okay. So in traditional database, so whenever you want to retrieve data from the database, for example, so go to SC01, and if you want to change something in the like user profile, like is the mobile number is you want to update and the password you want to change, like this. So first you go to SC01 and enter the existing user now. So then we need to click on change. Why? Because I want to change something in the profile, user profile. So whenever click on change, the request go to database, presentation layer to application layer, application layer to database layer, and fetch the user details, and it displays the window. Okay. So here per second, database layer can able to send, can able to push 120 MB per second. Per second in traditional database, I'm talking about traditional database. In traditional database, the database able to push 120 MB data per second. Okay. If you take a high performance database, in high performance database, 100 GB per second. So you can observe here the variation. Where is 120 MB per second? Where is 100 GB per second? That is high performance. Okay. So it retrieving, so very fast. So retrieving very fast, like from database, if you want to fetch the data very fast compared with the traditional database. Okay. So why? The traditional high performance databases, it gives a fast access if you want to fetch the data from database. But if you try traditional database, we are able to fetch only 120 MB per second. Why? Because we'll discuss. Okay. So for example, if you take SAP, like if you take SAP ECC, we have three layers. SAP ECC, we have three layers. Presentation layer. Application layer and database, compulsory database. Okay. So whenever we send a request, like whenever we enter one T code, like SU01, okay, and it displays the window, SU01 window, enter the, if you want to create one user, enter the username, click on create. What happened? The request go to application layer for processing purpose. After processing, the data need to saved in database. Why? Because SAP having no space now. So the, ultimately, the data is stored in database only. So see here, this is the first step. Second step, and third step. It means the request need to be traveled three steps, and finally in third step data going to be stored. Three steps compulsory, the request need to be traveled. Okay, so for example, if you take SAP HANA, what happened? Presentation layer. This is application layer. So is a request to, so like a GUI. So this is first step and second step. There is no third layer. So whenever we enter the T code in presentation layer, the request goes to application layer and no need to go to database layer. So why? Because see here, the data is stored in RAM only instead of the hard disk. Instead of the hard disk, the data is stored in RAM. So RAM is available in the motherboard only. That's nothing but application layer. So that's why you are using minimum 128 GB RAM. Yes, minimum is 128 GB. So on 64 GB, okay, we install, we can able to install, but we are not able to perform backups, restores, recovery. For only, okay, SAP HANA is installed. Okay, this is installed. So after that, we are not able to perform anything. Why? Because there is no space. 64 bit is only for installation purpose. Apart from that, we can't able to do anything, like even users creations also. Okay, users creations, okay, but the backups, resource recovery is not possible. So that's why minimum is 128 GB required. Okay, so we'll discuss the hardware configuration. No need to go to database. The data is stored in RAM only, and if you want to fetch the data from RAM to presentation layer to user interface, but we are using hard disk also, but that is not treated as a database in SAP HANA. We are using hard disk also, okay, but if you take SAP ECC installation, hard disk is treated as a database. But in SAP HANA, hard disk is that's treated as a only for backups. Why? Because the RAM is volatile. It means whenever the power is gone, automatically RAM is going to be silent. Okay, so the data we need to like backups, restores, recovery purpose, we need to take the backup at a hard disk. Okay, so that's why we are using hard disk. For example, okay, we'll discuss the hardware's configuration. Understood this point? Okay, so that's why the SAP HANA is very powerful. Why? Because for example, if you take this is also treated as a database. HANA is a database, but already existing databases are there, traditional database, Oracle, DB2 DB, those are very popular databases. Okay, so whenever the new database comes into the market, we need to check out what are the features are available on the new database. Why? Because already existing databases are there, the people are already working on the databases. So whenever we buy a new database, that's very it takes time. Why? Because there is a new database.